Yo, what's happening, YouTube? Jugga here. Welcome back to another Borderlands 3 video. Welcome to the Disney Villains x Borderlands 3 crossover terror items event slash builds. This is your builds number 3. I have so many incredible things to show you guys in this video. So grab some popcorn and let's get into it. First of all, I have my very own handcrafted action skill called the Avatar Action Skill, and I'm gonna show you guys exactly what it does, how to use it with this Disney Villains x Borderlands 3 crossover event. I actually have a very special treat for you guys, seeing that it's the Halloween weekend. I'm gonna show you guys exactly what my items does on next gen, comparing it with my PC build. Here is your Disney Villains x Borderlands 3 builds. We got Amara as Ursula, Mose as Maleficent, Zane as Hades, and Flack as Jafar. And yes, these are all individual terror builds. Now, the thing about these builds is that three of these items in each build actually remains the same: the grenade mod, the shield, and the artifact. And that's because those are the base items for each individual build. We're gonna cover that right now as we go over those three items firstly in these builds. First up, we have the golden all-in messy breakup shield. This thing is beyond powerful, super amazing, and the way the golden touch comes off of it, golden touch is actually built into this shield. Golden touch is a separate shield built into this shield with 12 other shields, including Aurelia. So soon as you get up to a character's face, they automatically gets frozen into this crazy ice block. Oh my god, the brain's coming out of the enemy right there, because when you melee with this shield with the artifact combined, you actually have all elemental melee, which is totally cool. And if you look at your shield, it's always stayed topped up to the very full brim. Now if you actually lose your shield, it will regenerate super fast, and not only that, it actually stays topped up all of the time. And if it breaks, you will have that Sidorak feeling, which gives you bonus elemental damage on top of protecting you, because we also have the last stand built into it. How amazing is that? Speaking of the artifact, we have an amazing Berserker Cosmic Crater artifact right here. As soon as you pummel into the ground, of course you have all of these elements happening at the same time. We got the fireworks in the air in fire damage. We got the spark plug, element of ice mixed with lava on the floor, that every time you slam actually revolves into different elements, along with ice spike coming out of your body shooting at the enemy, doing all elemental damage. How amazing is that? And along with that, you have something very powerful, which I told you guys that the shield does, which is all elemental melee, which is super powerful. Next up, we have the grenade mod, which is a scorched earth grenade mod. Again, if you look at the anointments, fadeaway, phase grass, digiclone, and iron bear, those are only 4 anointments for the characters you are actually seeing, but there are 15 hidden anointments for all characters behind of this grenade mod. From the shield, the artifact, and the actual grenade mod itself, you have hidden Easter eggs and terror anointments built into all three of those individual items, but when combined, does amazing things. So as soon as you throw this grenade mod, 2 little grenades come out like eyeballs, popping out, then explodes into this radiation cloud, then reverses, look at that, reverses in real time, then explodes into shock fireworks while dropping money at the same time. How cool is that?
That's cool. Nice. Real nice.
Well, thank you, Queen. Always a pleasure to have you here. And at the same time, like I said, you're doing Disney magic, because there's no grenade mod in this game that actually reverses like that in real time and then fast forwards and play like nothing happened while dropping money in a beautiful animation cloud exploding into shock fireworks. Next up, we have what you've guys been waiting for. Each individual builds weapon weaponry. Now we have Amara's Blood Beast, which is actually all elemental with a primary element of shock that has special Amara and Terra Amara anointments. We have Flax Blood Beast, which is all elemental as well, fire primary element, special Flax and Terra anointments. Then we have Moe's Blood Beast, all elemental as well, with a primary element of corrosive, special Moe's and Terra anointments. Finally, last but not least, Zane's Blood Beast, which is all elemental as well, with a primary element of cryo, with special Zane anointments and Zane Terra anointments. Next up, we have their individual Disney X villains crossover event class mods. These are Terror class mods with Terror anointments and as well as individual character specific anointments. Like Amara has her own anointments with her own class mod multiplied with Terror anointments. Same thing with Flack, Zane, and Moe's. How cool is that? Tell them, Wade.
Oh my god.
Not only did I actually put all of those anointments built into these handcrafted new Terra class mods, but I actually gave your characters extra skill points so you guys can use your new skill points to 65 in different areas of your trees. Or if you want to multiply those skill points, you can actually double up on some or actually triple up on some, taking you above the limit. How amazing is that? Okay, now it's time to show you guys how the Avatar action skill actually works, what it actually does, and how my handcrafted items compare to PC, which will be close to PS5 and the Xbox Series S and X. And this is actually how it looks on the PS4 Pro compared to my PC build using a 2080 Ti. This is important because I want to show you guys that what you guys are actually getting when you guys are, you know, purchasing from my shop or getting free items, that you're actually getting more than you bargained for. When I handcraft these items, I'm looking for a certain feel and experience for you guys to go out there and have new fun ways to play Borderlands 3 with my handcrafted loot. And that includes animations, which actually adds to the experience, which is the feel, the look, and the design, giving you a new fun way to play. Now you can see that console actually cuts my animations in half, taking away from half of that experience. Nevertheless, my items are amazing on console. I'm just letting you guys know that I'm actually creating more than you guys are actually getting, which is okay because my items actually transfers over to next gen console, and you guys will get to see what you guys are seeing on PC on next gen console because of the hardware upgrade. So my items will actually be upgraded automatically when you transfer your save from old gen to next gen. How cool is that?
That's cool. Nice. Real nice.
Now, when you actually activate your action skill for any character with these specific builds you guys are looking at right now, you actually activate my Avatar action skill on top of your regular action skill, which adds to your experience, fun, and gameplay at the same time. So when you activate your action skill, my Avatar action skill automatically gets activated, shooting out 4 discs, Mali 1 disc, aka orbs, in all different elements, which actually cycles through different elements and then explodes into that respective element, while at the same time doing damage to enemies and killing them. And at the same time, an orb of electricity storm comes out of your body, attacking and killing the enemy. While at the same time that is happening, you're actually dropping a healing rift upon your body, healing you and your Iron Bear and Pass all at the same time. How amazing is that? Tell him, Queen!
Oh my god, that's hot. Super hot.
Now, before we actually get back to the builds, I want to show you guys another handcrafted items animation hardware test using last week's Jubilee Phoenix X-Men Terror Grenade mod. You can see on the PS4 Pro, which I actually modified to make it better with an internal Samsung ME2 1TB SSD, making it faster so that animations load faster on the PS4 Pro. Now, you can see everything looks really nice on the PS4 Pro, but when compared compared to PC,
everything just looks so much better, which gives you an additive experience and new ways to play Borderlands 3. You do not have to worry about it. Like I said, next gen will be able to handle my animations that I create so that you guys can have more fun. Don't worry about old gen. The items are still there. You still will get that experience. Just with those new gen consoles, you will get more experiences. My loot actually works on every single console, including PC. Now, you can see on PC that the skull actually has details in it. You can see Bud Stallion, the diamond shimmering reflectiveness coming off of Bud Stallion on PC with rainbows and everything happening. While on PS4 Pro, all you can see is half the animation of that. Whereas you guys can see the corrosive puddle on PC actually has other elements like fire and ice. Whereas on PS4 Pro only has one element of corrosive. Now check this out. Upon throwing the grenade mod, you can see how everything happens in real time and looks more better and actually flows better. Now those terror skulls has additive animation of swirls and actually exit out with a fade animation, to whereas on PS4 Pro they just pop out. There's no additive animation to give you guys a new feel. Nevertheless, there's still amazing handcrafted loot for you guys for old gen, new gen, and PC. The shop supports everything for everyone. Next up, we actually have the Disney Villains X Borderlands 3 Terra Build. Amara becomes Ursula, that Disney villain, when you have all five of these items attached. And I'm going to show you guys exactly what happens when you have this full build attached to Amara. So check this out. As soon as you activate your action skill, whether it be Face Slam, Face Grasp, or Face Cast, using Face Grasp right here, Terror Skulls comes out of my body, killing the enemy while they are phase grasped. At the same time, my avatar action skill gets activated and destroys the enemy, or actually just elemental damage to them. Well, you can actually finish them off with your blood beast, which is all elemental with a primary element of shock. And of course, you got Aurelia shield going off right there. You guys seen the enemy try to attack me from the back, and the shield of Aurelia actually froze the enemy before he got to me. How cool is that? Then slam on the ground with my artifact, doing all of that elemental damage around my body, killing the enemy. And at the same time, if I need ammo, guess what? The white elephant is actually on this artifact that gives you the ability to regen ammo. And the Terra build, it just goes on and on, actually gives you regen ammo at the same time. How cool is that? Next up, we have Zane as Hades in this Terra build with all five of these items attached, makes this full build, which is totally incredible. Now we're gonna go over that build together. Now I'm gonna showcase you guys really quickly. Activating my action skill, boom, there goes the avatar action skill being activated at the same time. And while in that shield, powers up the avatar action skill, doing more damage because Zane has that ability to pack a punch any of his weapon. You guys notice if you're a Zane player now with this avatar action skill, guess what? Using it within your shield actually powers up your avatar action skill at the same time. And while your action skill actually depletes, you're actually activating that terror lightning bolt from your body. And at the same time, you have a Nova Blast around your body going off while your action skill is active, while at the same time dropping a healing rift to heal you. How cool is this? This is super amazing. Now, if you guys are actually having a hard time with Zane and the grenade mod is giving you a little bit of a problem because of your console and the hardware, just so you guys know, you have the ability not to spec into drone delivery that actually drops a free grenade, or if you're using DigiClone, that drops that free grenade as well, which will actually enhance your experience with Zane and this build. Also, built into the class mod, Zane automatically does not throw a free grenade, so you as the player have that experience or that option to add to your experience. If you want Zane to throw the grenade randomly, or the drone, or his digiclone, now you actually have the ability where you can control that. Me personally, I rather it off, activating my action skill right there, activates my avatar action skill at the same time, killing the enemy right in front of me, which is super dope, and at the same time adding to my fun because I do not have to worry about the grenade going off every single time. If you do want to use that grenade and drone delivery or a digiclone throwing a free grenade, or while you shoot, throw a free grenade at the same time using a Scorched Earth grenade mod, I highly recommend that you use it for PC that can actually handle it on Zane only or at the same time. Wait for next gen and use it, because your next gen console will be able to add that, which adds a different and new experience. But you have control as the player, you have control over this build to choose which experience you would like to have, which is super amazing. Remember, if you actually run out of ammo, just slam on the ground in a pool of enemies and you will automatically get back ammo for your weapons for Zane, or go into that terrified mode by activating your action skill, and you guys will actually regenerate ammo at the same time. Next up, we have Moe's as Maleficent. This is her terror build, which is so amazing. I'm gonna show you guys exactly how this works when you have five of those brand new terror items equipped to Moe's. Now, Moe's Terra's Blood Beast is actually super amazing, because you guys have all elemental and at the same time primary element of corrosive, which taps into that green monster attached to this actual class mod, and at the same time still does amazing amount of splash damage. Because if you're playing as Moe's, of course you want that splash damage. You guys can see right there, going crazy, super powerful. And of course, when you press down on the D-pad, you actually have two different firing modes with that Blood Beast, along with every single character. But with Moe's, of course, that splash damage means everything to you. Now, you guys can see, once we're Iron Bear, once we hopped into Iron Bear, we activated our action skill of Iron Bear, and at the same time activating our avatar action skill, giving Iron Bear over 10 million shield, and at the same time dropping that healing rift. You guys can see doing the actual lightning bolt out of my body, and Iron Bear's weaponry actually does all elemental as well. So not only you're shooting rockets, but those rockets now have elements attached to it. There is nothing like this in this game that does that, other than what I've created for you guys to use. And at the same time, Nova Blast coming out of Iron Bear's body, killing the enemy as well. Next up, we have Flak as Jafar, and this is his terror build. With these five items attached to Flak, you have now just made him that Disney villain of Jafar. Now, I wanted to show you guys something extra special. Now, I know you guys actually seen in the hardware test earlier in the video exactly what the avatar action skill actually looks like, but I'm gonna show you guys right here. I'm gonna slow it down in the big mode, showing you guys right here that you guys got all of those elemental drones about to go into elemental explosion right there, using gamma burst, taking my pet to the next level. Of course, all of these avatar action skill actually work for the fourth skill tree, so you're actually buying into your future of fun with my items here. Now, you guys can see Flak right now is doing a Nova Blast while my pet is active, and at the same time, which is constant, like a siren power mixed in with Flak. And then you have my pet, who has its own power of an elemental red lightning going around his body, which actually adds to my pet's weaponry, because my pet now attacks in all elemental damage. How cool is that? Now, Flak's Blood Beast, which is actually fire, primary element of fire, does all elemental damage as well. Down on the D-pad, you guys have that burst mode, which gives you guys a scope that zooms in, which is actually pretty cool. Down on the D-pad, flips back to that full auto mode, and at the same time, you can go crazy. You guys can see, once I'm terrified, that I actually have unlimited ammo for that short time, which is cool, and it adds to your fun and replayability here in Borderlands 3 with my handcrafted terror builds, which is so amazing. Giveaway time. Now, I know you guys have been waiting for this part of the video, especially because I give back to you guys, because you guys support me and watching all of my videos, hitting the like button and actually commenting. Actually, we forgot to do our like goal this video. So before we get into the giveaway, can you guys do me a favor and drop a like on this video, and let's see if we can break our new like goal of 66 likes. You know what I'm saying? Because it's Halloween, why not go with the sixes? And if you guys want to take it a step further, let's do 666 likes. Let's get it right now. All right, so let's do it right now. Giveaway time. Now, because you guys support me so much, I'm giving away one full build in the comments comment sections to 3 people on PSN, 3 people on Xbox, and 3 people on PC. On PC, please put your shift name. That's what I mean by shift ID, your shift name, okay? And I got you. First 3 people on any console and first 3 people on PC, put your gamer tag, PSN, or shift name, and let me know which full build you would like, and I will send it to you for free just for subscribing to me and having notifications turned on, because you guys are awesome. And if you actually miss your chance to get it for free, you can actually purchase any of these items, including the build, in my item shop right now. First link in the description at evilxjugshop.com. Shop is now open. Shop will be closing in a day and a half. So right now is your chance to get these items. If you miss your chance this weekend, next weekend, it will be back, but some of these items will not be here. So make sure you get your items right now. Remember, by Sunday night PST time, all items and all bills and all orders will be delivered to you. So just be patient. I promise I will get to you. So until next time, remember, treat yourself this Halloween season. Don't cheat yourself. Trick or treat. Love you guys to the fullest. And until next time, I'm Jug. See you here for another one.
Evil X, just go let the credits roll. Hey! I am the walker of sky. My name is eternal. I will never die. I will go down as one of the greats, one of the ones that everyone hates. If it's the fame or if it's the infamy, I will get up to the top of the industry. This is my story, and I am the author, the story of Skywalker.